Kimchi stew is a very popular Korean lunch meal. I grew up here, but my DNA is still Korean. My body craved it. Hi, my name is Hooni Kim. I'm here today to cook kimchi stew from my new book, My Korea. Before we make kimchi stew, we need to make a dashi. And dashi, I consider sort of the natural MSG. It adds so much flavor to everything that we do. We use water, dried shiitake mushrooms, and some dried anchovies. You want to soak this overnight, and when you do, you only have to heat it about an hour and a half. You don't want it boiling, but you also want it to sort of be hot enough where you could see the steam coming out. While the dashi is working, we're gonna start making our kimchi. First thing we have to do is brine the cabbage. Just need to cut it in half. I like to put a little sort of a cut here so it can absorb the salt a little bit more evenly. Cabbage kimchi is what Koreans call just plain kimchi, and every other kimchi, like radish kimchi, there's an adjective before it to describe the specific kind of vegetable. The acidic, salty, sweet flavor cuts through some of the fatty dishes that we'll find in traditional Korean meat cuisine. You do wanna salt a little bit on the outside, but also on the inside as well. So between each layer, if you can get a little bit of salt. Ultimately, you want this to be completely soaked so it brines evenly, but that's not gonna happen right away. I like to add a little water in the beginning, and after 2 to 3 hours, I come and check to see that it's completely immersed, and I usually like to flip it at least once. This is gonna take about 12 hours. Luckily, I have cabbage that's already brined. It shouldn't be too soft. That means that you brined it a little too long, but it shouldn't break when you sort of bend it like this. You want to taste the cabbage, you want it a little bit salty. The salt will actually really help the sweetness of the cabbage come out. Now we're ready to make the marinade. So it's pretty simple, just water and rice flour. Heat it up and make sure you whisk well so it doesn't burn. And you're looking for a texture that's like Elmer's glue. And you only have to cook it out for about 10, 15 minutes. So to make the marinade, I'm gonna peel some apples, garlic. In Korea, like the whole village used to come together, and once a year we used to make kimchi. And basically the whole village shares the kimchi. You take a share, some of it home, you store it underground to keep it cold, you let it ferment, and that's your year's supply of kimchi. When you use a catalyst, like for instance today we're using salted shrimp, fermentation starts happening pretty soon, 3-4 days, and you can see the actual texture and the flavors change. I've had kimchi that was 10 years old, and it still had that crispy cabbage texture like it was just made yesterday. We're gonna add a little bit of salted shrimp. I'm gonna use a little bit of dashi to make sure that this mixture mixes well. You also want to hydrate your red chili flakes. If you hydrate it overnight or for a couple of hours, you'll get a brighter red color. There's no scientific proof of that, but most Korean mothers and grandmothers will tell you and swear by it. Okay. We're gonna add the puree mix. Basically, you want the texture to be a little bit loose. You don't have to use all of the paste. It's viscous enough that it'll stick to the cabbage. We're gonna add scallions, just sort of little batons. This Japanese radish is daikon. We're gonna start marinating. We want to get in between the leaves. And because there's such a color contrast, it's pretty easy to see if you've missed a leaf or not. Because there's salted shrimp in there, there's anchovy sauce in there, it'll start fermenting by itself. Now, fermentation is best at around 33 to 35 degrees Fahrenheit. It needs to be airtight. I actually like to use plastic wrap to make sure that there's no air. And you want no sunlight or any kind of light. And you wanna close this as well because it is gonna start to smell. Ideally, I don't think you should open this until 10 days and see how the fermentation is going. Sometimes it takes 3 weeks, sometimes it'll be a little bit less. To make kimchi stew, you want to use kimchi that's really aged. This kimchi has been aging at one of my restaurants. You can tell the color is deeper, it's redder. All the marinade has sort of seeped in and the flavor's deep. It's perfect when you cook it with some pork fat, and that's what we're gonna do. First thing, pork belly. I actually like to use skin on. Bite-sized pieces. If it has little bits of bones, actually it helps flavor the broth, so I like to keep it in there. A little bit of oil. Pork. Salt. You're rendering the fat out as well as giving it a little bit of color. I'm gonna chop some of the kimchi. Take the core out. Just bite-sized pieces. Now, because the kimchi is aged and it's very acidic, you do need something to balance that out. And that's where the pork belly comes in. The fattiness of the pork, it really balances and neutralizes some of the acidity. The flavor from the kimchi comes out a lot faster after you've sauteed it. You're gonna saute just about 5 minutes. It's always good to add a little bit of extra garlic. And gochugaru. The gochugaru, the red pepper flakes, is actually for color. Don't saute the red pepper flakes, gochugaru, too much, because it does tend to burn. After about a few minutes, we're ready to add the dashi. Let this come to a boil. In about 20 minutes, the broth is gonna taste really good. It's actually really, really flavorful. Sometimes it might be a little too bold, then you can add a little bit of dashi. We're gonna add tofu. You put the scallions and the tofu in. Close the lid again. Cook for just about 2 minutes. In Korea, traditionally, we just bring the whole stew to the table and we eat it family style with rice. It's a wonderful deep broth. You can taste the strength and the power of the kimchi. You're eating something that was alive and kept alive for 8 years through fermentation. It has so much probiotics in there that's good for your gut biome. On a cold winter's night, this rich, thick broth is wonderful. For the recipe, click the link below. And also, you can find the recipe in my book, My Korea.